Leave the gun. Take the cannoli.
I'm gonna make him an offer again.
Funny how.
What's going on, chuckleheads? I am Carlo Guadagnino. This is Dingo Talk. Today I'm going to go through the schedule for the Steelers and kind of make some predictions, see where I think they're going to land, and go from there. So the Steelers schedule was announced as well as the NFL schedule, and the second half really weighs out really well. Well, it is Saturday, and I'm sure I knew I was going to get interrupted. I thought I'd get a little further into my show than this, but hello, AJ. Welcome back.
How you doing, Carlo?
You know, as well as you can do when you're in quarantine.
Yeah, how's quarantine treating you, by the way?
I mean, I still go to work every day, so...
Yeah, same here.
So, AJ, today's topic, not really serious or anything. It's just the schedules for the NFL. I figured I would focus on the Pittsburgh Steelers, and I'm guessing that you're calling in because you're going to talk to me about the Kansas City Chiefs.
Yeah, I mean, we can focus on whoever you want to talk about. I mean, of course, yeah, Chiefs and Steelers will probably be the two teams we cover, but if you ever want to throw in any little gems, let's do it.
All right, well, why don't you give us the Chiefs schedule? And we'll go through that, and then after that, we'll go through the Steelers schedule.
All right. Well, I mean, I'm not going to sit here and read out the whole schedule, but so the Chiefs host the Texans, first game of the year, Thursday at home. I'm not worried about it. Texans, I think after losing DeAndre Hopkins, I think they're going to struggle big time. I don't think the Texans are going to be very good this year. Then they go to the Chargers. I don't think that's going to be an issue. My issue is Monday night, week 3, at Baltimore. So the Chiefs' issue is they play Baltimore on the road. They play Buffalo on the road. They play Tampa Bay on the road. They play New Orleans on the road. And it's one of those situations where the Chiefs could very well go 8-0 at home. But they're going to struggle on the road. They're going to be very battle-tested going into the playoffs.
I definitely agree with your analysis. I have that about the Texans as well. I think it's just a team that's in a rebuild, and whatever wins they get this year, good for them. But their goal is – I don't think – actually, I'm not going to sit here and act like either one of us know what their goal is, because I don't think Bill O'Brien knows what the goal is right now. So.
His goal is to try to be GM and head coach at the same time.
And it's obviously not working on either front. So, to your point, that is a that's kind of like a murderer's row there for a couple weeks.
Yeah, here's the thing, though. To have them all on the road, it would be different. Now, here's the thing, though. Realistically speaking, I'm not worried about going to Tampa Bay because I think the Chiefs, like, here's my thing. I would be, if Tom Brady was still in the Patriots, even though everyone says, like, oh, he got all these offensive weapons, like, I would be more scared to go to New England with Tom Brady than I am to go to Tampa Bay with Tom Brady. I think the Chiefs will blow out the Buccaneers.
All right. Well, AJ, as you know, I do enjoy to have a drink while we're doing this show.
And, yeah, same here.
Apparently, with that statement that you just made, apparently you are in one of the ones who did you start a little early today? Like, I mean, the show just started, and you're talking reckless. Listen.
No, that is not a reckless statement.
Listen, this is still Tom Brady. The guy's still a quarterback. Now, the weapons that he has in Tampa Bay, to me, give him a better potential than what he had in New England left. Gronkowski does not factor in for me. I mean, if he comes back and he is in good shape and a freak, then, I mean, I don't know. That's going to be a scary offense. To say that the Kansas City Chiefs are going to blow the doors off of Tampa Bay, you're wild. You're wild.
Here's what I think. You want my reasoning?
I'll listen. I don't think it's right, but I'll listen.
In New England, the offense was a little lackluster, but he did have a solid defense. Whereas in Tampa Bay, yes, the offense is a lot better, so they may score points. But their defense is not stopping Mahomes from putting up 50. So honestly, if I had to make a prediction, because it's like they might score points, but I believe in the Chiefs' defense to stop Tampa Bay's offense more so than I believe in Tampa Bay's offense or defense to stop Kansas City's offense. And I would say it's probably going to be 53-28, if I had to guess. Chiefs.
That's a bold prediction. I mean, listen, I don't think anybody should want to get into a shootout with Tom Brady.
Even
Patrick Mahomes, man, I think that you're talking about a guy, and listen, I'm not a Tom Brady fan, but you're talking about a guy that walked away from New England and really is trying to separate himself from this, I'm a system quarterback. I only have what I have because I was with Bill Belichick. And listen, the guy was good enough to win the rings that he won, be it by Pete Carroll making a blunder and Atlanta's
or David Tyree making the helmet catch,
and the Atlanta Falcons having a miserable collapse. But this dude's still a pretty damn good quarterback, and you give him young weapons. Do I think the arm strength's gone or not there at what it was? Absolutely. Do I think he's still Tom Brady? Yes. Do I think it's going to be great to watch him go against Drew Brees twice this year? Absolutely.
My whole thing is, don't get me wrong. I'm a firm believer in Tom Brady. I will easily sit here and say he's the greatest quarterback of all time. But the point I'm making is, and you touched on it by saying that, oh, he doesn't want people to think he's a system quarterback. I don't think it was more so people thinking that he was a system quarterback, because he made so many receivers great in New England. There were so many seasons where he played with nobody. And I think his year with Randy Moss, he was unstoppable. And Randy Moss was unstoppable. And I think going down to Tampa Bay, I think now that he has these weapons and stuff, it's like, imagine.
Wait. What are you saying there? You just said two different things. You just said, to first off, you said that Tom Brady didn't have, he made receivers.
Yeah.
But then you put Randy Moss in that category, and I know you're not trying to tell me that Randy Moss made Tom Brady.
You don't think Randy, no.
Like, Tom Brady made Randy Moss.
No, the point I was making was he made receivers day in and day out, and then I said he got Randy Moss.
Oh, yeah, towards the end of his career. You're right. Okay, it was a misunderstanding.
Like one of, like, the first, like, big wig names he ever got.
Yeah, I mean, I just think that everybody in the league has called Tom Brady a system quarterback. He is good because the system provides for him. And I don't necessarily know if that's true. We're going to find out this year.
Call it a system. I just believe once you're with a team that long and you have the same head coach for that long and you get to know the staff and you're very comfortable. Yes, if that makes you a system quarterback, then yes, he was just a system quarterback. But well, my problem is he was very comfortable being in New England, because once you're there for that long and you've done what you've done, it's like he's almost gone around Boston. And it's like, I'm Tom Brady, and people bow down. Whereas now he goes to a Bruce Arians offense where it's like an air raid offense. Is the offensive line going to be able to contain the rush?
Well, the sack issue wasn't
stop people from killing Tom Brady, because we all know Tom Brady ain't moving.
The sack issue wasn't an issue for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers last year. The fact that they had a guy.
Yeah, Jameis Winston threw it up and prayed.
Okay, so if they could keep Jameis Winston upright for long enough, I think that they're going to do quite all right with Tom Brady.
Jameis Winston's a lot more mobile than Tom Brady.
That provides problems with the protection at times.
Don't get me wrong. Buccaneers might make playoffs, but like I said, this is about the Chiefs' schedule. Somehow we got derailed. I believe the Chiefs will go into Tampa Bay and blow them out. The games I'm worried about are at Buffalo and at New Orleans.
Not Baltimore. You're not worried about Baltimore.
I need another year of Lamar Jackson to believe in Baltimore.
Okay, that's fair enough. I mean, I happen to believe.
To you, I think Steelers win the division. Big Ben stays healthy. I think Steelers win the division.
Okay, well, again, I think that you sort of shouldn't have started drinking at noon.
I did.
But
I took a little cat nap today.
Yeah, I know. I'm aware. I wasn't allowed to take one.
Well, yeah, because we had to shoot this.
No, I had to shoot this. This is on my time.
What am I doing right now? Just interrupting?
The caption of this is probably going to be AJ interrupts again. All right.
You love me, Carlo. The people love me.
So, is that the only part of the schedule you want to talk about? You don't want to talk about anymore on your schedule?
No, I mean, okay. I mean, if you want to get into the division itself.
Yeah.
I mean, then also go to the Dolphins, first things first, before I get into their division.
Mm-hmm.
I'm excited to see what Tua does. Because that's around December, so that's late in the season. I'm excited to see how Tua develops and whatnot. But the division itself, I am very excited about. Because the Broncos have gotten better. The Chargers have gotten better.
Mm-hmm.
And Vegas moved into a new stadium.
Well, yeah. See, I think Denver's a year away. I think that they're still young, but they're going to be exciting.
How do you feel about Locke? You like him?
I do.
He is moxie.
He's, you know. So, is that so? What's your final prediction for the Kansas City Chiefs? And we'll take a break here, and maybe I'll come back and we'll talk to you about the Steelers.
Being a Chiefs fan, of course I'm going to be optimistic, but if you want me to be realistic. 11-4
11.
They're not 11. 11-5, 10-6, somewhere around there.
I think you're missing a game, my friend.
No, 10-6. No, 11-5.
Remember they added that extra game this year, so there's a 17th game.
No, that's a playoff game, I thought.
No.
Look, I'm counting right now.
Okay, let me know.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12,
13, 14, 15, 16.
16 games?
16 games?
Yeah.
Oh, plus the bye. You're right.
Yeah.
So, optimistic is?
Optimistic would be 13-3, but realism, 11-5.
Real 11-5. All right. So, AJ thinks the Kansas City Chiefs will finish the season 11-5. But optimistically could see them going 13-3. He's not worried about Baltimore. He's not worried about Tom Brady in Tampa Bay. He's worried about New Orleans. He's worried about
who else? Josh Allen and the Buffalo Bills. Because you know why, Carlo? No one circles the wagons like the Buffalo Bills.
And on that note, that's how we're going to end part one of this, because I need to regroup after he just did that. 11-5. We'll come back with part two, and it'll be me talking to AJ about the Steelers and hopefully trying to educate him slightly. But we'll be back. Welcome to my new friend.